In April of 2005, Pat Tillman Sr., who's with us here, sent a strongly worded letter to Brigadier General Gary Jones, who was leading the Army's investigation into Pat's death. Here's another clip from the Tillman story.
I just went through and blew out just about everything they considered to be a fact and explained to them why that is a lie, and concluded by telling them that I have low regard for them. I just wanted to tell somebody off.
Unbeknownst to Pat Sr., the Army considered the wording of his letter to be a formal accusation of criminal misconduct. This automatically initiated a new investigation by the Inspector General's office.
He got the Silver Star, Pat, right?
He did.
Do you have that medal?
I do. Yep. I have one. Danny has one. I think Marie has one.
So you kept those?
Oh, yeah. I'm not giving that back.
What do you think of your government, Mary? What do you think of Rumsfeld, McChrystal, and the rest? What are your thoughts about this? Why?
Well, I don't think they're very honorable people. I know they were lying. I mean, and I think that, Pat and I are talking about, you know, we feel that there could have been something else that happened to Pat, but we can't prove it. Every bit of evidence has been destroyed. Unless someone were to come forward to tell us in new information, there isn't much we can do. But through the congressional hearing, the first congressional hearing, we do know that there was indeed a cover-up. The Oversight Committee deemed that there was. But people dropped the ball, Congress dropped the ball when it came time to find out who was actually accountable. Rumsfeld, Abizaid, Myers, and Brown collectively said, I don't know, I don't recall, I don't remember, about 82 times. And no one on that panel pressed them. No one did their research. Neither faction of that committee. I mean, there were a few very brave and courageous people on that panel, but for the most part, they dropped the ball completely. And I think what's sad about it, and that one of the main purposes for this documentary, and one of the reasons that I wanted to, you know, to republish the book that I wrote, is because this is not an isolated incident. Pat is not alone. There are many soldiers who have died in these wars, and the families are lied to. And it's outrageous.
Friendly fire is common in all wars, though, isn't it, Patrick? It goes back to every war ever fought. It's going to have friendly fire when you're out in a place and people and guns are going off.
They have books on it going back to the Civil War that I'm familiar with, yeah. And they have books going back to the Civil War that I'm familiar with that say you do not split the troops because it is very dangerous. But, you know, the point that we were trying to make, friendly fire does occur. Maybe it was an accident, probably was an accident, but the setting that we were handed was just unbearable. It was not even tethered to a fact. It was so manufactured that it made it tough to tolerate, and that's why we kept pushing on here. And no one has been held accountable about this matter.